गुड आफ्टरनून एट क्लास स्टूडेंट्स, नाउ वी आर लर्निंग अबाउट कंस्ट्रक्शन ऑफ ग्रुप्ड फ्रीक्वेंसी डिस्ट्रीब्यूशन। सी कंस्ट्रक्शन ऑफ ग्रुप्ड फ्रीक्वेंसी डिस्ट्रीब्यूशन। कंसिडर द मार्क्स ऑफ 50 स्टूडेंट्स इन मैथमेटिक्स secured in summative assessment 1 as 31, 14, 0, 12, 20, 23, 26, etc. After seeing the data, you might be thinking into how many intervals the data could be classified, how frequency distribution table could be constructed. Now, the following steps help in construction of grouped frequency distribution. Step 1. Find the range of the data. How to find range? The formula of range is maximum value minus minimum value. Now, the given data, you see, maximum value find 47, okay. Minimum value find 0, okay. Maximum value minus minimum value is 47 minus 0 is equal to 47. Step 2. Decide the number of class intervals. Generally, number of class intervals are 5 to 8. If number of class intervals is equal to 6, length of the class interval is equal to 47 by 8, approximately 8. Length of the class interval is 47 by 6, approximately is equal to 8. Step 3. Write inclusive class intervals starting from minimum value of the observations, that is 0 to 7, 8 to 15, and so on. Inclusive class intervals means 0 to 7, 8 to 15, 7 and next 8 is given. Okay. Step 4. Using the tally marks, distribute the observations of the data into respective class intervals. Count the tally marks and write the frequencies in the table. Okay. Length of the class interval is 8. Number of classes are, intervals are 6. Okay, you see the table. Class intervals mark 0 to 7, 8 to 15, next 16 to 23, next number 24 to 31, next 30 to 39, next 40 to 47. Okay, tally marks. You know the tally marks. How to write the tally marks? Okay, 0 to 7 marks. Frequency, number of students. 0 to 7 is equal to 4, 8 to 15 is equal to 5, 1, 6, 16 to 23 is equal to 5 and 4, 9, 21 to 31, 5, 5, 3, 13, 30 to 39 is 5, 5, 4, 14, 40 to 47, 4. These are adding total number of frequency or number of students 50. Okay,